I'm going to do a quick video of the stereo system in my car. This is a 2019 Ford Fusion Hybrid. I'm going to show you what I have for a stereo in this car. Right there is two Meso CT Sounds Meso 8-inch woofers and the ground shaker enclosure. Very nice enclosure, actually. I've removed the rear 6x9s and replaced them with these ports. These are aero ports. See the connector there? These centers have been replaced with CT Sounds Meso, and all the doors are Meso as well. Under the hatch, right here, is my electrical. There's the circuit breaker for the bass amp, and there's the circuit breaker for the mids and highs. And up here is a Maxwell capacitor bank on a little mount that I made. It's riveted to the metal. Has this little strap with the wing nut so I can remove it if I wanted to. It's all tucked up nice and neat and you don't see it. So we'll put this back together. We'll pull this floor out. Right there's that CT Sounds 3.5. We'll put the mat up there so you can see the setup down here. Right here is an AT1400.1 and an AT60.4. This is all in the spare tire hatch. This is not styrofoam, it's actually plastic, so it won't melt. Don't mind this wire here. This was running a small inverter the other day. You can see my connections here. These are 10 gauge going to the subs. These are tinned. A little bit of shrink tube indicating polarity. I've got this covering on here. This is oversized silver tinned 4 gauge. It's equivalent to a 1/0 OFC wire. The same wires used here. Kind of a little bit showing there. It's a very nice wire. You can see there the silver tintage on there. It's a very nice wire. Right here is the LC7i. So the way I'm running this, we got front, rear, and subwoofer outputs from the factory amplifier. Front, left, right, rear, left, right, subwoofer, left, right. These are the subwoofer left and right connections. Going to the amp, front, rear, and subwoofer. And they go here, you can see here, left, right, left, right, left, right, right here, left, right, and the subwoofers. This cable, these are bundled with this red stuff going under there. This is speed cable, and this is where the speed cable comes. You can see it here. You got your four channels with wiring and a remote wire. We'll pull this cover off right here. We'll set it up here. And behind this, I've already pulled these off so I can show you. Behind here is the wiring that I've chose to do. This is the factory Sony amplifier. These are the speaker output connections. All the twisted pairs minus this twisted pair here. This is a green and white twisted pair. This is CAN bus data. Do not cut these. Do not splice them. They must be connected for the system to work. If the radio senses that this amp is not connected and not working, then the entire radio will not work. So you can see This bundle is the outputs going to the LC7i from the amplifier. If you notice here in the connection, we have front, rear, right, left, right, minus, positive. They're the same. So the way these are connected in there, everything on the top is plus, everything on the back is minus. These are front channels, except for the center on both of these are the subwoofers. So that center set, subwoofer, subwoofer. The thicker sets here, these two, are the subwoofer. These two are the front. These two here are the rear. Okay, so coming out of the speed cable, this black one, is another set of connectors. And you can see here, they're feeding only to the outsides. You can see the insides have nothing. They are right here. Those are for the factory subwoofers. By rights, I should have connected those to here, and I probably just forgot to do so. It won't be nothing to crimp the little ends on there and stuff them in the hole in the right spot so they match up here. Because ideally, I can unplug this, plug this into there, and then it'll backfeed properly as if it was a factory setup. And it'll backfeed all the speakers as if they were connected to the amplifier from the factory. The speed cable, you can see, goes to the front, right, left, minus, positive, rear, left, right, minus, and positive. So that's how those are connected. And this kind of hangs behind this panel here. So I can unplug this one, plug these two together, and it'll backfeed the system, and it'll power the entire, it'll power the doors off of this amp. And if I reconnect these, which I will probably do later this afternoon, and it will power these connectors, so I can put the 6x9s back in the hat rack and pull those off and have the factory subwoofers connected to the factory amp as well. So back door, all the screws undone, so I'll pull this off and show you the setup that I have in the doors. For those who may be curious, all four doors are identically set up, so there's probably not a need to show every single door. I could just show this one. Unplug the connections here. So like I said, all four doors are identical. This is a CT Sounds Miso 6.5-inch driver. It's very nice. It's got like a fiber type cone, aluminum machine basket, really nice speakers. Got some second skin deadener on all the doors. The back doors have less than the front doors. They're just kind of patched in there. They really don't vibrate that much anyways. And here's the Miso tweeter. I used the factory tweeter and kind of just gooped the Miso tweeter on there. If I sell the car or wreck the car, then they're going to go with it, I suppose. I had these same setup in my 2016, and I was rear-ended, and the insurance company paid for all of the stereo that was in the car. There's the Miso 3.5. That's where the ports come out, right there. They vent into the cabin. Very nice. You don't have to leave the back open or anything. You see I have a car seat in there. I don't have to leave this back open to get all my bass out of it. I can stay closed all the time. Here's the inside of the car. I don't know why this camera is so shaky. You can see the capacitor takes a minute to charge up. So this will go up to 14.3, 14.4, it'll stay there. That's how long it takes for the capacitor to charge up. If you turn the car off, it'll actually drain back down to whatever the battery sits at, 12 point something. Why I went with this setup with a capacitor instead of an extra battery, because it'll match the voltage of the factory system and I don't have to worry about the two batteries fighting each other.
You drink too much and that's an issue, but I'm okay. Tell your friends it was nice to meet them, but I hope I never see them again. I know it breaks your heart, moved to the city and I broke down crying. 4 years no calls, now you're looking pretty in a hotel bar.
So, really not a bad sounding system at all. It's kind of nice actually. It's all hidden. Everything's put away nicely. Everything kind of just fits in there. Even on top of the hybrid. You only have 11 inches from the bottom to the top of this plastic right here. You can see this ground shaker enclosure is about 3/4 inch from that. So, just fits. It's pretty good. Of course, these mesos, they really thump. Man, they thump. Especially on 1400 watts or a mess. These don't get hot at all. People ask about that. People say they're getting... it's gonna get hot. Well, you buy good amps and then they don't get hot like that, even though it's underneath of there. Let me know if you got any questions. Try to answer anything electrical related if anybody needs help. Of the Ford Fusion Hybrid stereo install. Neck frozen, wrist.
drunk off that liquor. I can't trust these hoes, but you look so different, girl. You got your girls, I got my niggas. So you should tell your girls to come fuck with us. Come live in the fast lane. Bottles every night, whatever you like, cause a new thing.